All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503. Okay, man. I'm coming live from Portland, Oregon. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time, whatever it is. Thank you. Now, let's get into this, man. Our conference is the Pac-12. I try to break down the duck video. I do that. Go check out those videos if you're interested in that. And then I go through the whole Pac-12. Now, Pac-12, a little bit of a tough week, but hey, man, first week is tough. So I want to try to do this each week. I'm not a big fan of prognostication. I'll try to give you guys who I think is going to win and stuff, but I'm not going to like break it down and get into my little data of win-loss record. I try to just give an overview of what's going down. People, let's do this thing, okay? So our first one was Utah. I think Utah is a hell of a team. I think Utah might be the best team in the South. Again, last year, if you guys were watching, I thought Utah was the best team. And then I thought they were the second best team, and then they were the third best team, then they're the fourth best team, then they were back to the first best team, and they kind of have a roller coaster. This year, I think they're going to be good. They got the good, solid coaching staff. They got one of the best coaching staffs in the conference. Say what you want to say. I like Utah. I think Utah is a hell of a team. Utah, and then, you know, Southern Utah, what are you going to do, right? So then they got Oregon State, Minnesota. That was the game I was really excited for. I had to go pirate on the internet and try to find that thing. That was a bitch. But Oregon State really showed up, did a great job, much, much, much better than I thought they would. And you know what? Maybe Minnesota had a tough game. Maybe Minnesota was overlooking the Beavs a little bit. Maybe this is who Minnesota is, and maybe the Beavs are better than this. You know, maybe the Beavs last year, it's their first season, they're getting their feet wet, you know, whatever the deal is. They look a little bit better. They have a little bit better identity. And I like the quarterback better this year than I did last year, even though there was some quarterback issues. There were like three different quarterbacks last year. Colorado looked good, man. Gotta like it. You know, Colorado had a tough run the last couple, 3 years. It's good to get that. And it's good to beat Colorado State to start the year off. Who the hell doesn't like that in the state of Colorado, right? Rocky Mountain Showdown or something they call it. So that's a big deal. Now, Stanford's the pride of the conference. They're the Rose Bowl pick. They probably still will be and will be for the rest of the remaining of the year until hopefully Oregon beats them. But they played K-State. I don't know about K-State. Looks like they are kind of the same team they've always been. You know, they're going to get drummed by a team, but they're really always kind of keep themselves in it. 26-13, Stanford beats them. Stanford is better than that. McCaffrey is awesome. He had one called back. McCaffrey's probably going to go to the Heisman Trophy candidate ceremony this year. And you know what? If no one else shows up in the conferences, maybe he wins because he is the best in the Pac-12. Offensively, there's no denying it. Now, it'd be great to see Royce get a sniff. It'd be great to see Royce get good numbers. But I think this year you're going to see a lot of the three or possibly even four running backs for Oregon. You know you're going to get three. So he's going to be sharing the load with two other guys. Let's do Washington Rutgers. Washington is actually everybody's favorite for the North, and why the hell not? They're returning a good defense, and they've got a good offense, and Coach P is a good coach. And they got the hell of a conference, man. They got that North. They got that great. They're in Seattle or on the lake. Oh, Lord. So they had a good one. Rutgers, you know, Rutgers can be a tough game. Washington State had that a couple years ago. 48-13. Now, UCLA, A&M. I liked A&M all this offseason. But UCLA had a really good run at this. They actually came back in the thing. They look pretty good. But the receivers are dropping balls. Rosen's probably the best quarterback in the conference. He just doesn't have the receivers to match with it. And that's the thing about college football, man. You never know what you're going to get. It's always a mismatch. Never have a full team ready to go. You always have one part of it that's young and one part of it that's old or one part of it that's, oh, Lord. It's just a mismatch every year. So you get a kid like Rosen. He's got a great arm and he's got a great future, but, man, he can't throw the ball to anybody. Kind of like Goff at Cal. Okay, let's go back to this thing. Oregon beats UC Davis. We talked about that in the other video. That's what was expected. Again, it wasn't that big of a deal for us. If you're a real Oregon fan and you're really diehard and you want to jump off the ship because they lost, you know, we're down in the first quarter, whatever. And then Eastern Washington, man, I'm telling you, Washington State's done this before, and, you know, they've rebounded from their schedule. You know, they lost to Portland State last year, year before, whatever it was. They rebounded. I think Washington State still can, but you got to stop somebody. I've said this the whole time. You can't let Eastern Washington put 45 points on you. You got to stop somebody. Last year, we couldn't stop anybody. Hell, we let Washington State beat us at home in overtime because neither of us had a goddamn defense. So, That's just expected. You're going to see that. I do not think that Leach is on the hot seat. I think that it's better than it was, but it's still, if you're a Wazoo fan, you're pissed. You are severely pissed. So, sorry, man. SC, if you thought SC was going to beat Bama, okay, please. SC hopefully is better than they used to be, and they're off this sanctions or whatever, but SC is not going to beat Bama. Bama's the number one team in the country. They're the goddamn returning favorite. They're like the Yankees in the 20s and shit. They're just dominating. And they were close in the first quarter. Hell, you go back to the Oregon game, talk about the first quarter. You go back to the SC game, talk about the first quarter. SC was ahead in the first quarter, right? And then they just get drummed. 52 points. And Alabama's scoring points now. I mean, you got Kiffin over there. That had to suck for some SC fans to see Kiffin hammering them like that. That's tough. Okay, and then you got BYU, Arizona. This was the game of the whole freaking weekend. I mean, unless you're a UCLA fan, that was a great game as well. But this game was just phenomenal. At the end of the game, then you finally have an Arizona have an opportunity. And then, oh, two-point conversion, man. You got to have that thing. And then BYU with the sneak attack. After Mendenhall goes over there and loses, that's got to feel good for the BYU contingency, okay? Then you have Arizona State. Arizona State beats Northern Arizona. Arizona State, I think, is a wild card. You never know what you're going to get down there, okay? So I like Arizona State, maybe third place in the South, something like that. Okay, let's do next week. I'll do a real quick one here, just give a quick rundown, see what I like, see what happens. Be a little, let's go with this one. Jimmy the Greek, right? Okay, boom. SC plays Utah State. They will rebound. They'll get their victory. A-okay. Washington plays Idaho. Idaho's played some teams tough, and they kind of play low scoring. Washington drills them, probably. Idaho State plays Colorado. Colorado goes 2-0. I love that. BYU, Utah. This is awesome for BYU. BYU comes off of a huge opener to go into their absolute hated rival. This is so epic, and it's great that this game is even happening, because this game is not a scheduled game year after year. This is kind of a contract year. This game is going to go away in the future for a couple years, then come back, and this is not like an every year thing as it was for like 100 years, right? So this game is epic. This is going to be the game that I'm really excited for to watch. And then you got UNLV, UCLA. UCLA should beat UNLV. This should be good for UCLA. Get themselves back together. And you know what? You can't take a moral victory from anything, but you lost in overtime because your receivers couldn't catch the goddamn ball. You catch a couple balls, you beat A&M at A&M. That's a huge victory, okay? Texas Tech at Arizona State. Now we get to see a little bit better Arizona State look. I still like Arizona State to beat Texas Tech. I don't really know much about Texas Tech, but if Texas Tech shows up, hey, let's do this thing, right? I like Arizona State, though. Let's see what we got. Washington State, Boise State. If there's a week to not play Boise State for Washington State, this is it. You come off the loss to Eastern Washington. Now you got to rebound and go right Boise State. Nobody likes to play Boise State. I don't care who the coach is. I don't care what color the turf is. Nobody likes to play Broncos, okay? So that's a pick 'em game, in my opinion. I think Washington State rebounds. I think they actually turn it on, score 40 points again. Everything's okay. Now, Colorado. No, Cal. What am I talking about? Cal's playing San Diego State. Aztecs. Why not? Cal had a tough one. You know, they had to go all the way down to Australia to play their first game. So they get a little rebound week. Hawaii didn't. They get a little rebound week. And now you get a situation where they get to play San Diego State. I like Cal in this one. Hopefully Cal gets to rebound this thing. Let's get this thing back to going, because I like the Cal when Cal is good. I like Cal Oregon. I like all Cal Washington. I like all those games when Cal's good. When Cal's not good, it's not very fun to watch those games. Okay, Virginia, Oregon. We talked about this in my little Oregon video. I do like Oregon in this one, but you know what? I think Virginia is going to rebound heavy off their loss. I think Virginia is going to be a lot like Washington State, pissed off, ready to go, rebound this thing, go hard. Now, Grambling State at Arizona. This is crazy. I didn't even know this is great. I love this. But I think Arizona wins this game. Now, holy smokes, people. Rebound City. I think Pac-12 had a really kind of a tough first week. I think they get a good second week, and I think they rebound themselves and put themselves back into the conversation of being the deepest conference in the league, or being the deepest conference in the country. And if you're the deepest conference, well, you're in the running for the best conference. Whether the top is as good as everybody else, no, it's not. But, hey, maybe we got 8 teams that can compete better than everybody else. Only everybody else has maybe 4 or 5 teams. Huh? Okay, let's go check out my other videos. If you're into this stuff, if you're digging it, great. If you're digging my scene, cool. If you're not, hey, I'm all right with it. I don't need the hater, but if you need the hater, cool. I'm cool with it. Let's go. If you go check out my other videos, though, leave some comments, man. I'm cool with it. I'll comment back. Let's do this thing. Let's chat. Okay, people, adios.